I am Christelle from Diabetes Strong, and I got my hands on a Libre 2 reader or receiver and a Libre 2 sensor. So I thought, let me do a Libre 2 review. Before we talk more about what is the Libre 2 and how can it support your diabetes management, let me just get the sensor on and the system up and running. Now that we're up and running with the Libre 2 sensor, I'm gonna wear it for the full 2 weeks, which is duration of the sensor, and I'm gonna record how I like it so that I can include that in the end of this video. Let's briefly go over what Libre 2 is before I get into the review. Freestyle Libre 2, or just the Libre 2, is a continuous glucose monitor, or a CGM. So what that means is that it will keep track of your blood sugars without any finger sticks. And it's currently FDA approved for anyone the age of 4 and up. You'll be able to see your blood sugar readings by either holding up the receiver or the app on your phone directly up to the sensor, and it will then display your blood sugar reading on the screen along with a graph of your last 8 hours of readings. It'll also give you an arrow. So it'll show an arrow saying, okay, are your blood sugars stable? Be a flat arrow, rising or decreasing. The sensor updates every minute, but it has an 8-hour memory. So that means that you have to remember to scan the sensor at least every 8 hours. The big difference between Libre 1 and Libre 2, and today we're talking about Libre 2, is that Libre 2 offers alarms. That means that you will automatically be warned. You don't have to scan. The system will automatically warn you if your blood sugars are high or low, or if you lose signal. But it does require that you're within 20 feet of your receiver at all times. The Libre iOS app was approved in August in 2021. So that means that now that I'm recording this video, the Android app has still not been approved. Since the iOS app was just approved by the FDA, it was actually approved while I was wearing my sensor for this experiment, I could only use the receiver. So this review is going to be based solely on me using the receiver for the Libre 2 system. Please note that as with any other CGM system, it's not considered accurate enough for dosing right off the bat. So on the screen or on the app, you will see a little magnifying glass and a blood drop. And you'll see that for the first 12 hours. And that's simply the system indicating that you should not base dosing decisions off the CGM just yet. Overall, I really enjoyed how small the sensor is. It didn't bother me whatsoever. The insertion was painless and it stayed on for the full 2 weeks. It was also fairly accurate. Let's talk more about that. I generally found the Libre 2 to be accurate. I did a comparison to both finger sticks and I also wore a Dexcom G6 and they were all within 10 milligrams per deciliter of each other on average. I did find that the Libre 2 gave me slightly lower levels than my finger sticks did, but it wasn't really significant and it wasn't consistent. The way I look at this is that for a system to be not trustworthy, I would say that it would have to consistently be off and it would have to be off more than the 10 milligrams per deciliter. The way I think about it is that would 10 milligrams per deciliter change my management decisions? And the truth is no. If my blood sugar is 150 or 140 milligrams per deciliter, it doesn't really matter. It doesn't change how many units of insulin I'll take. I only had one Libre 2 sensor, so all my experience is based on one sensor. But I did have quite a few sensor errors with this particular sensor, as well as some receiver errors. All of these errors resolved themselves, so I didn't have to contact Abbott to get a new sensor. But it's obviously annoying when the system doesn't work. And unfortunately, one of the sensor errors was when I could see on my other CGM that my blood sugars were dropping rapidly. I had 2 arrows down, and that's not really a situation where you want to be without your CGM. The Libre 2 receiver, I didn't love it. I had to use this when I was wearing the sensor simply because the app, the Libre 2 app, was not yet FDA approved. Funny enough, it was approved halfway through me wearing the sensor, so after a week, the Libre 2 app was FDA approved for iOS only. So that means still not for Android. If you have an Android phone, you still have to use a receiver. The reason why I didn't love it is, well, first of all, it's another device to hold around. and I would actually forget it quite often. Second is the battery life is not amazing, probably because of the alarms. It vibrates, you can also put on sound, but the battery would last me about 24 to 36 hours. I'd have to remember to charge it overnight. Also, it's not amazing quality, and it did give me quite a few receiver errors. The Libre 2 alarms are fairly basic. You can set a high alert, you can set a lower alert, and you can set a sense of loss. And you can either set it to vibrate or with sound. But they're effective, and I would hear the device even when it was on silent. Let's talk integration with other devices. Right now, the Libre 2 is kind of a standalone device, at least here in the US. It will be integrated with the Omnipod Horizon when that comes to market, but that's not here yet. So right now, you won't really be able to see your Libre reading on any pumps or integrated in any smart pens. So it's a standalone system. Now let's talk price. I check my insurance, and my insurance covers all CGMs at a daily rate. So that means that Libre would cost me the same as it cost me for a Dexcom system. And that's about $70 a month. But you need, that's for me, you need to check your insurance to see, do they even cover Libre and at what price? Because that can make a huge difference on whether or not this system is for you. If you had to buy the Libre 2 cash, so it means without insurance here in the US, the list prices that I found for one sensor, so that's for 2 weeks of sensor wear, was $60. So that's $4.30 a day. Overall, I think the Libre 2 is a great CGM solution. It's easy to use and it didn't feel intrusive. It's not as sophisticated as other CGM systems, such as the Dexcom T6. However, if this is what's in your budget and you're not looking for system integration with insulin pumps, then this could be a great option. Thank you for watching my Libre 2 review. If you enjoyed this video and like to see more from me, please click the subscribe button and you'll be informed whenever I post new content. I always appreciate any interactions, so please give this video a like or a comment below. Thank you so much for watching.